Okay, it was about time. And I'm not talking about shaving or having a nice haircut like I do. Can you see it? Huh? What do you think? Oh, isn't he beautiful? No, I'm talking about burn-in, vertical bending, temporary image retention on my LG CX. Okay, calm down, Markus. Anyway, why I'm doing this video is because my Let's Plays, no one is watching. So that's why I need to do different topics. Or content. Actually, that's not true. Two people are watching my Let's Play. So thank you, Tom and George. But anyway, now seriously, I did a lot of Let's Plays with Ghost of Tsushima, and always when I play this game, and this game is sometimes playing in the dark, and you have a monochrome, color like the sky or whatever, and then you move around. I was able to see vertical bending, and I'm very sure over the time it got worse, in my opinion. So, of course, I can't prove it, but I think that the first time when I started the game, it was noticeable, yes. But with the last part, what I did, I don't know, part 13 or whatever, it was so annoying that I decided to check if actually my vertical bending is worse. And what I found is, really, I think it is much worse. Okay, so let's start talking about vertical bending. And how do we do this? We have this nice test video, which is always running in the background, what you can see. And what is a little bit interesting, so I turned this TV on, let's say, maybe an hour ago, and I did a quick testing before I started the video, and I was actually very surprised, because the other day when I checked with the same test pattern, it was absolutely worse, absolutely. And this was, I think, 2 days ago. And since then, I haven't played any games. I just watched TV or did some calibration testing whatsoever. And today I tested and I was absolutely surprised. I couldn't find this big issue again. But it's still, noticeable, and in my opinion, so the last time, 2 days ago, when I checked exactly on the same parts on the TV, it was much worse. And the only thing what I can think about is so first of all, vertical bending is not coming from the pixels or from the OLED pixel, it's coming from the different diffusers on the panel. Is it diffuser or... Yeah, I think so. Diffuser is the right word. But anyway, on top of those OLED pixels, OLED pixels, there are a lot of diffusers to make sure that the picture is this what you can see on the screen at the moment, okay? What I really think is, because the other day when I did the test, I think 2 days ago, whatever, it was actually a very warm day. So today is actually a very cold day, just 20 degrees in this room. So it's very cold. And the other day it was 25 degrees in this room, plus the TV was on for much longer time, much, much longer time. So maybe already for 5, 6, 7 hours. So, and I think that because the TV was much warmer the other day when I did the testing, the diffusers, of course, reacting differently to warmer weather or warmer temperature than to colder temperature. That's just normal. It's just physics. But that different, it's a really big difference, what I think. And I can't prove it today because I'm running out of time. I really like to do this video, and what I will do is, weekend is coming, I will leave this TV running and on Saturday for, let's say, 10 hours with this test pattern, so it's get nice and warm, and then I do another video just to compare. That's why we're doing this video today with an hour running TV at 20 degrees. And then we compare in a couple of days with the next video. So before we start with the testing now, or with test pattern, I have to say something. So if you're new to this channel, then you have now the chance to subscribe to my channel. Later on, I will not accept it anymore, okay? So subscribe now, or wait. I think this was enough time. So if you haven't subscribed, don't make me come after you, okay? You know, I don't want to do this. Okay, let's start the testing after this little threat. No, I mean, hey, talking friendly here. Just let me turn off all the lights because it's very hard to see anything. Oh, this one as well here. I bought this for, by the way, I bought this for $60. Amazon. It's great, huh? Great, really. Yeah, I have to save. I like to have a pool in 2-3 years. Yeah, I have to. Yeah, anyway, different story. Okay, let's start with bending test or vertical bending test. And the camera is actually making things much worse than in real life. Really, it's like this because, let me stop here. This was maybe a little bit too, just give me one more time. Because I like to have a very nice, I can switch to other test pattern as well, but let me try again. Oh, and of course the camera has a very hard time to focus here. Okay, this was perfect. So what you can see here on the camera at the moment, it's really, really worse. Can you see this? This vertical bending stuff, all this little, the differences in the brightness. This is not what the, let me turn this off as well. Okay, can you see this a little bit? I hope so. So it's very hard to see from my, or with my eyes at the moment, but with the camera, I clearly can see it. And then when I see it with the camera, I can see everything here. And this is very, very annoying. And at the moment, it's really not that worse. Believe me, it's not that worse. I did the same testing with 5% test pattern and we changing to 5% soon. Can you see this? All these different the stripes. Okay, let me turn on the light again. Just to talk to you. So on all the stripes, what you can see on the camera, I hope you were able to see because it's every 2-3 centimeters you can see this. It's so annoying when you turn, you know, the picture and you have a monochrome color, then it's really, really annoying. So, and let me show you with a 5% test pattern the same thing. Okay, so we are back with 5% test pattern, and I'm sorry, the camera is really, really struggling here. I need to make a little bit of light. This is too much, way too much. Just give me a second. Let me see if this is working better. Yeah, it's very hard for the camera. But even then, can you notice it? I'm able to see it on the camera much better than on the real screen. Okay, let's change to, let's say 10%. Can you see this? It's a little bit, now the camera is a little bit sharper, but it's harder to see this, the vertical bending. But I'm very sure you're able to notice this, huh? It's getting harder, of course, when I'm going far away. But here, can you see this now? I think it's very obvious at the moment what I'm talking about. So, of course, when I'm changing to 15 or 20 or whatever, at some point you can't see it anymore. If it's getting too bright, the picture, the monochrome color, then it's almost gone. But here, even here, you have a very nice, bright, yeah, vertical stripe. Yeah, but it's much better, of course. And with 20, it's almost gone, I would say. Yeah, still a little bit. So, the same thing with colors. Let's talk about 75% color. Let's say red. So with colors, I have no issue at all. So even, of course, if you go down to 25% color or whatever, because the background from the colors is then 100% white, so it's you can't see any issue with the colors. So the colors are really perfect. And of course, I have to say, so because this looks worse at the moment, so believe me, it's not, okay? It's not. I'm playing with TVs or having TVs since I can afford them, okay? So in my best time, I bought up to 2 TVs a year. So this was many, many years back in Germany. Oh, I earned a lot of money, yes. And I wasted a lot of money on this crap, yeah. Anyway, and even with the high-end plasma TVs from Pioneer, which I had, I don't know, 3 or 4 different types, and my last was the 5080 XD, I think was the name, what a full HD Pioneer. It was worse. It was absolutely worse. And when you did testing, that's, by the way, the exact same test pattern what I'm used back then. So they are really old test pattern. With the red, and I can remember this absolutely. I had a big, big black spot here. And this was according to the technician back then, because of course I asked a technician to come and have a look on my TV, what is going on. He said to me, this is normal. This is state of the art at the moment. They can't do anything better. Which was, of course, not satisfying, because back then I spent a lot of money for a 50-inch TV with full HD. Anyway, so vertical banding, it is noticeable, and I'm very sure when the TV is on for a longer time, it will get worse. So, burn in. There is no issue at all with my TV with burn in. And I know what I'm talking about because I'm doing a lot of calibration lately. And what does it mean when I'm doing calibration? Means really you talking about, where is it? Let's say pictures like this for hours. Okay? For hours. And what happened then is I have a big issue with temporary image retention, because you can imagine this test pattern or all the different test pattern in this size are on the TV for hours, you know. And of course, when you go then to 100% color, or even 100 or 50% grayscale or whatever, okay, you need a full size, okay, my bad, but you know what I mean. Or where's my fields here? So when I'm going then after a couple of hours testing to, let's say, 100% red, you can absolutely see this field, of course. And not just for a couple of minutes. No, not just for a couple of seconds, sorry, for a couple of minutes. But every time after, when I check after, let's say after 10 minutes, 15 minutes, it's absolutely gone. But of course, I think it's not the best what you can do for a TV, because when I'm doing the calibration, this particular screen or part on the screen is getting used heavily and the rest is just not used. So I think over the time, if I'm continuing doing testing or calibration like this, I will have an issue with this particular zone on the TV. And this is my, actually, I don't understand why we can't have test pattern. They are somewhere else, you know, then I can do more testing. But anyway, so that's so far for this video, I would say. Again, there is no issue with burn in. You can, if you want, we can have a look. So especially yellow, what I played lately is Windbound or whatever, or Ghost of Tsushima, yeah. Ghost of Tsushima, there's really nothing. Really, believe me, in terms of burn in, there's no problem. But even here on the yellow, I can see vertical, not horizontal bending, you know, in this direction. Absolutely clear, visible. I don't know if you can, if I'm going a little bit further. No, it's very hard to see because there are very, very minor stripes here. Don't know if you can. But anyway, so the horizontal bending is not an issue at all, because most of the time the picture is going from left to right or whatsoever, even on soccer or whatever game you're watching. and it's not a big deal. But the horizontal bending, of course, it is an issue. Okay, anyway, that's for this video. So vertical bending, I will make an updated video in by tomorrow evening. And let's see what the difference is. But you had a chance to see it, and I'm very sure in the beginning it wasn't like this, and it's very annoying. It's annoying me at the time, with the time at the moment, and not sure what I'm doing. But still, it's much better than the TV I owned before, especially LCDs or plasma TVs, and still happy with this because picture quality is great and gaming on this TV, just a dream. Anyway, okay, thank you very much for watching me, and just subscribe, okay? Thank you, see you next time.